Worst case scenario, it's true. Because if it's true, this guy has just inadvertently published supporting evidence to show that Hunter Biden's money, the money he was getting from Burisma, was going to his dad, Joe Biden. The Washington Post just dropped a bombshell. Either that or it's printed the worst opinion article in history.
Mr. Reagan.
All right, so the Washington Post just published this opinion column by David Ignatius. David Ignatius, he's been around forever. I feel like he's probably just destroyed his entire career with this opinion article, which will inevitably be used by the rest of the mainstream media to pretend that the Hunter Biden story is some kind of debunked conspiracy theory. Let's get right into it. I'm going to read you this article. It's entitled "The Truth Behind the Hunter Biden Non-Scandal." And this is the flakiest article I've ever read in my entire life. All right, it starts, "The story of Hunter Biden's involvement with Ukrainian gas company Burisma isn't a scandal about his father, as the Trump campaign claims, but part of a personal tragedy for the vice president's son, compounded by this week's dissemination of what looks like disinformation about Joe Biden's role." Yes, disinformation. It's ridiculous that he uses the word disinformation, because what is that code for, right? That's code for Russian disinformation. The whole rumor right now amongst leftists is that this whole idea of Joe Biden's involvement is somehow Russian disinformation. But hilariously, in this exact article, David Ignatius inadvertently incriminates Joe Biden. He unintentionally points directly to Joe Biden's role, as he puts it. So this idea that it's Russian disinformation, well, you've either produced more evidence to indicate that Joe Biden had a role in this, or this whole article is total garbage and you should be fired immediately and never work at any newspaper ever again, David Ignatius. All right, well, what is this bombshell? We will get into it in one moment. First, of course, I have to sell you something. So I actually used to do keto, which is actually a really effective diet if you can do it right. But my problem was that I literally ate so much fatty meat that I didn't lose any weight. No joke. I ate steaks like every day. It was fantastic, but I didn't lose any weight. Most people struggle with keto, though, because they have to give up carbs, not because they eat too much fatty meat. And just one bite of carbs can ruin your results because of how ketosis works. But you can actually mitigate this problem with this stuff right here, Keto Elevate. You've probably seen me advertise it on the channel before. Now, a buddy of mine actually turned me on to MCT powder a while back, and even though I'm on more of a paleo diet, I still use Keto Elevate. Keto Elevate will increase your energy, improve your appetite control, and provide you with a noticeable boost in mental clarity. I just add a scoop of it to my morning coffee along with BioTrust Collagen, another excellent product from these same guys. With Keto Elevate, unlike the typical keto diet, I can still support elevated ketone levels and many of their benefits despite having a few carbs. And I mean, I don't go crazy. I still keep my carb count under control. You got to be responsible with your diet, folks. But this stuff definitely helps. And with every order, BioTrust donates a nutritious meal to a hungry child through nokidhungry.org. So that is very cool. It's like you're supporting the channel, you're giving to charity, and you're improving your health all at the same time. It's fantastic. Get your own bag of Keto Elevate for 51% off and free shipping by going to ketowithreagan.com. or by clicking the link in the description below. All right, so let's have a look. He writes, "What's clear beyond the false scandal mongering has been evident for years. Hunter Biden made a mistake getting involved with a dubious company like Burisma." Yeah, he had no idea. Poor Hunter Biden had no idea what he was doing. Tragedy. "But the notion that the Burisma affair undermines Joe Biden's case to be president is, as he would say, malarkey." Yeah, there's nothing here that undermines Joe Biden's case for being president. He's just totally and utterly corrupt. What's so bad about that? That's not so bad. He writes, "The Joe Biden campaign has been understandably reluctant to respond for fear of giving the story legitimacy." Yeah, that's why they're not responding. "Still, Biden has said his son made a mistake. Family friends say the vice president is reluctant to publicly criticize Hunter Biden further, but they stress that both Bidens have learned a painful lesson that the president's children should stay away from international business. Would that the Trump family recognize that rule." Yes, let's criticize Donald Trump. It's the Trump kids that we should really be focused on. It's really Donald Trump Jr. He's really the scumbag. I mean, don't ask me what it is, but I'm sure it's terrible. He writes, To provide perspective, I talked this week with a business consultant with extensive experience in Ukraine, whom Hunter Biden contacted in early 2014 as he was considering joining the Burisma board. The consultant strongly urged against this move, but Biden, struggling with personal and financial issues, pressed ahead. The danger that Hunter Biden's Burisma connection might be misused was illustrated soon after. Burisma posted a photograph on its website of Devin Archer, Hunter Biden's business partner, standing with the then vice president before an American flag at what appeared to be the White House. That's the whole reason that they hired Devin Archer and Hunter Biden. That's the only reason they hired them, so that they could post pictures like this. The only reason they've got them there. And so, of course, that they could gain influence with the vice president, which they exploited in an unbelievable way. But let's move on. Archer, with Hunter Biden, joined the Burisma board in the spring of 2014. The consultant who requested anonymity, how convenient, this magical consultant that you conferred with requested anonymity. So we have no idea if anything in this article is true. The only reason that we have to believe it at all is that it's written by David Ignatius, and it's in the Washington Post, which, as we all know, is the most honorable newspaper of all time with the highest standards of journalistic integrity. The consultant who requested anonymity said he urged Hunter Biden through a friend to... Okay, so he didn't urge Hunter Biden. He urged him through a friend. This is all sounding totally legit. The consultant who requested anonymity said he urged Hunter Biden through a friend to have Burisma take down the photo, and it was removed from the company's website that day. A copy could not be located, but the Biden campaign doesn't dispute that it may have been taken when Archer visited the White House in April 2014 with his son. The Hunter-Ukraine connection has been a political sideshow since the Biden campaign began. It got new voltage this week when the New York Post published what it claimed were emails from Hunter Biden's laptop suggesting that he helped arrange a 2015 meeting between his father and a Burisma executive. The Biden campaign denied any such meeting and its accounts based on recollections. Okay, oh my God. All right. The Biden campaign denied any such meeting and its accounts based on recollections of multiple staff members are believable. Really? They're believable by whom? By you? You believe them. So they must all be true because David Ignatius said that they're believable. Okay, we all accept that. Sure. An Eastern European expert in digital forensics who has examined some of the Ukraine documents leaked to the New York Post told me he found anomalies such as American-style capitalization of the names of the ministries that suggest fakery. But I don't see his name on here either. So apparently there's a mysterious Eastern European expert in digital forensics that you also don't give us the name of, who apparently told you that there are some discrepancies. You know what's interesting here is that this is in the opinion section of the Washington Post. So whomever he is contacting here, none of these people have to be real. This is an opinion piece. So this, all of these people could be imaginary people in David Ignatius's mind. He could have just made them up. None of this has to be actual fact because it's not in the, it's only in the opinion section. But this is not written as an opinion piece, mind you. This is written as if it is news, as if it is all legitimate. So this is bull. This is all horse manure, let's call it. He continues, people in personal trouble, as Hunter Biden was in 2014, often ignore good advice. So he's a psychiatrist now, and he's trying to figure out what Hunter Biden's mindset was at the time. And he's trying to convince people that, like, you know, Joe Biden doesn't have anything to do with this. This is just a poor, psychologically sick young man in trouble and, you know, trying to get out of it as desperately as he can. And, you know, and this is just a big mess. And let's just forget about it. It's just an ugly mess that we don't need to talk about. It's just someone in personal trouble. That's all. People in personal trouble, as Hunter Biden was in 2014, often ignore good advice. And that seems to be the case here. Like, don't smoke crack, for instance. The consultant, elaborating on a fragmentary account I reported in March, told me that he was approached in the spring of 2014 by one of Biden's friends who was worried about his plans to join Burisma. The consultant said he met Biden and the friend for drinks at the Ritz-Carlton Hotel. Okay, so apparently he did meet with Hunter Biden in Georgetown. Biden described the discussions between Burisma and his company, Rosemont Seneca Partners, which he had founded 5 years before with Christopher Heinz and Devin Archer, both friends from Yale. Biden asked the consultant about some of the Ukrainians involved with Burisma, whom Archer had encountered in Kiev. Burisma was pursuing new gas leases in Ukraine that it claimed might attract international investments. The consultant remembers and wanted prominent people on its board. What they don't tell you is that the guy who owned Burisma was actually in the Ukraine government. I mean, what people don't probably realize about Ukraine and a lot of these former Soviet countries is that the oligarchs who control a lot of the wealth, who own many of the businesses in these countries, are also in government, right? So it's as if Bill Gates or Elon Musk or who does Apple? Cook? Whatever his name is, Cook. If those guys were all like senators, right? If you had all the owners of all the major businesses in America, if Zuckerberg was Speaker of the House, for instance, right? So if all these heads of businesses, if they were the people in the federal government running the country, that's what Ukraine is like. So a lot of times, these people running the government will set up the laws and set up all the stuff to benefit their businesses. And so this is what was happening with Burisma. So we were getting all of this aid to Ukraine, but a lot of that money was being funneled into Burisma so that it would eventually just be stolen by the oligarchs, which is exactly what happened. But in order to get a lot of that funding, you know, what did they do? They brought in Hunter Biden. One thing that really bothers me about this is a lot of conservatives are only going after the most easily provable part of this story, right? Which is the bit where Joe Biden went to Ukraine and he had the special prosecutor fired, Shokin fired, in order to protect Burisma because his son worked at Burisma. But what people don't think about, and I've done this in tons of videos, I talked about this, so I don't really know why this isn't more popularly known, but like if people would just think about it for half a second, Joe Biden was controlling a bunch of money, a bunch of aid money going into Ukraine. A bunch of that money was going to flow into Burisma. And Burisma, totally coincidentally, hires Joe Biden's son, Hunter, for a job at the company that he knows he has no experience for and starts paying him obscene amounts of money, right? This is either a bribe or this is some kind of a deal that was struck or something, but there's corruption here, obviously. It doesn't take a genius to figure out that this is some kind of sneaky deal, that this is corruption, right? This is very obviously corruption, but nobody talks about that. They only talk about when Biden went in and had the prosecutor fired, because that's the obvious thing. That's the obvious bit of corruption. But the whole setup is corrupt. The whole thing is corrupt. The whole thing is flowing money into Hunter Biden's bank accounts. The one thing I always wondered about is whether or not Joe Biden himself is getting a little bit of a taste of that cash. And we'll get to that here. Let's continue. So apparently Burisma wanted prominent people on its board, he says, right? The consultant made some inquiries about several senior Burisma executives and then met with Biden a week later. All right, so apparently this made-up person is claiming that he met with Hunter Biden. The consultant told Biden the planned Burisma gas licenses involved small assets that weren't likely to attract foreign investors and cautioned the vice president's son against working for the company. So he didn't warn him against working for the company because it might be a total and ridiculous conflict of interest. It might be seen as complete and utter corruption by Joe Biden. No. He cautioned him not to join because, you know, it was just small assets that actually wouldn't really work out financially. That's the advice that was given, apparently. If this guy even actually exists. They're using you for your name. They will exploit your name to your detriment and to your father's, the consultant remembered warning Biden. Biden responded poignantly about his need for income, the consultant recalls. My mom and dad don't have money. Bo, Hunter's brother, now deceased, will run for office. I have to make money for the family. And this, ladies and gentlemen, this is the bombshell. I have to make money for the family. All right. So if this is true, which I don't really think it's true, but if this is true, if this article is legitimate, if there really was some kind of a consultant that talked to this reporter, and if the consultant really did talk to Hunter Biden, and if Hunter Biden did actually say, I need to make money for the family, then this is an indication that the money that he was making in Ukraine was going to Joe Biden, at least some of it. There are two other indications that Joe Biden made money from this Ukraine deal. One of them was a Hunter Biden text to his daughter where he said something about you don't have to give half your money to your dad, right? Unlike Joe Biden. So he's saying, he's essentially saying in the text message, I give half of my money to Joe Biden, my father, Joe Biden. But this is another piece of supporting evidence to suggest that Joe Biden was making money out of whatever it was Hunter was getting from Burisma in Ukraine, a country that he was approving aid to. American taxpayer dollars was going to Ukraine. Money that was approved to be sent by Joe Biden was going to Ukraine, into Burisma, into the pockets of Hunter Biden. And then Hunter Biden was distributing that money back into the family, back into Joe Biden's pockets. My mom and dad don't have money. Beau will now run for office. I have to make money for the family. This is huge. If this is true, this is a huge bombshell because this is more supporting evidence. If you can get this guy under oath to say that, in fact, Hunter Biden indeed said that he was trying to make money through Ukraine to support the family, that is an indication that this whole thing was a scam set up by Joe Biden and Hunter Biden to make money for the family. Now, here's the thing. This is a ridiculous statement. And this is why I suspect that this entire opinion article is totally bogus journalism. And this is why it's in the opinion section, right? Because my mom and dad don't have money. Your father is the vice president of the United States of America. At the time this was said, his father was the vice president of the United States of America. What do you mean, mom and dad don't have money? What? Unless the whole problem here is that they're not living like billionaires. Yeah, they do have money. They make hundreds of thousands of dollars a year as vice president. You're getting paid a pretty significant sum of money. That's a much larger salary than most Americans, first of all. Secondly, you have security 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, right? Secret Service. That's like millions of dollars a year. And then they get all their expenses paid, right? Anywhere Joe Biden needs to fly, paid for by the government. You need to have lunch with somebody, paid for by the government. Like, this guy lives like a billionaire, better than almost anybody in the country, Joe Biden, and he doesn't pay for any of it. It's all taxpayer funded, every penny of it. You don't have to pay for almost anything. You have no expenses, Joe Biden. How is it possible mom and dad don't have any money? That just, I mean, it just doesn't sound, it sounds ridiculous, okay? The only situation that I could imagine him saying that, and this would be potentially legitimate, is if Joe Biden bought so many things, had so many bills to pay, that they were legitimately running out of money. Like, you know, because we already know that Hunter was involved in some stuff with China, where he was working with some Chinese companies that were connected to the Communist Party there in China that were giving, you know, Hunter's company millions and millions of dollars to deal with. I think billions even were going through Hunter's company. And so Hunter was making a ton of money on that as well. So it's possible that maybe some of those deals dried up, or there were some other situations where, you know, they got used to a certain kind of income, they got used to a certain kind of lifestyle, and then they were afraid that maybe it was going to end, so they needed more money, and so they had to set up this Ukraine deal. But either way, this is terrible, right? My mom and dad don't have money. Beau will run for office. I have to make money for the family. If this is true, if this is accurate, then this is a bombshell. This is supporting evidence that shows that Hunter Biden's income from Ukraine was going to Joe Biden. And if it's not true, then this journalist, whatever, needs to be fired from the Washington Post. Not that the Washington Post has any kind of integrity anyway, but they should fire him and he should never work again as a journalist. Those are the two options. Let me continue. Biden said he planned to join Burisma as a director. Family friends say he was struggling with a drug problem at the time and his judgment was erratic. About a month later, a photo of Joe Biden with Archer appeared on the Burisma website. The consultant phoned and texted Hunter Biden without response and then contacted the mutual friend who had connected them. This is the kind of nonsense I talked about, the consultant said, he warned. Evidently, someone contacted Burisma, the consultant said, because the photograph disappeared. Archer, like Hunter Biden, joined the Burisma board in 2014. As a director, Biden received $50,000 a month. He received more than that. The Biden campaign said Joe Biden's tax returns before and after he left office showed he didn't receive any money from Hunter Biden. Because it's impossible to just fill a suitcase full of cash and just give it to dad. That's not possible. That could never possibly have happened. Archer left the company in 2018 and Hunter Biden left the next year, because they knew they were utterly corrupt and they were about to get caught. In 2018, a federal jury convicted Archer on a fraud charge involving bonds for a Native American development company. I'm actually shocked that he put that in here. That is true. And he continues, a verdict reaffirmed this month by a federal appeals court. I suppose he put that in there because he knew other people would find it as well. Yeah, so we're not exactly dealing with, like, angels here, right? Yeah, nothing shady about these guys at all. All right. Joe Biden said in January it was a, quote, mistake for his son to join the board and promised that if he becomes president, none of his family members will have, quote, any involvement with any foreign government at all. Oh, that makes me feel so good. I just want to vote for Joe Biden. I promise. If I'm president, pinky swear. I promise, guys. No corruption from my family. No promises about me personally. But Hunter won't be doing any more of that stuff. He's learned his lesson. Hunter Biden, too, said he made a, quote, mistake, for which he bore, quote, full responsibility. That's the sort of self-criticism we rarely hear from Trump or his family. This guy is trying to turn this situation into, like, a plus for the Bidens. Can you believe how great these Bidens are? They realize that they made a mistake, and they're taking full responsibility for it. Wow, that's just so great. You know, it's like whenever I see a murderer talking about how he realized that murdering that person was probably a bad idea because now he's caught and he's been put in prison and he's, like, facing the death penalty, I think, wow, what a great guy. That's the sort of self-criticism we rarely hear from Trump or his family. Oh my, they somehow turn that into a slam against Trump and Trump's kids as well. But, like, what? Because they never did anything like this. The Trumps are not horribly corrupt like the Bidens are. They don't need to take full responsibility for anything because they didn't do anything wrong. Let's see here. This, he says, is smoke without a fire. Hunter Biden erred. Made a little mistake. Made a little boo-boo. His father said so, quietly but clearly. He should get on with the business of trying to put the country back together after Trump's ruinous presidency. Darn that Trump. You know what, guys? It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what Joe Biden has done in his career. It doesn't matter how corrupt he or his son has been. Just forget about all that. Donald Trump has had a ruinous presidency. Ruinous. And we need Joe Biden to come in, put things back together. Yeah. Forget the fact that Donald Trump had one of the most prosperous presidencies in the history of the country. Maybe the most prosperous time in American history was when Donald Trump held the reins, right, before coronavirus obviously screwed everything up. Forget about that. No. It was Trump's ruinous presidency. There's nothing ruinous about Trump's presidency. There's something ruinous about coronavirus. This is the end of the article, by the way, so we're done reading. It's just analysis now. Sorry, guys. Now, you got to understand, this journalist, the only reason that this opinion piece was put in the Washington Post is because this journalist is a well-respected journalist, right? And this newspaper is, by some people, idiots, a respected publication. I can't even believe I'm saying that, but yeah. But the thing is, this is all such garbage. This is such a bad article. This is such baloney. And even if it's, look, best case scenario for David Ignatius, best case scenario for the Washington Post, best case scenario for Joe Biden and Hunter Biden, this was all made up. This is just a BS article. It was total horse manure, right? Worst case scenario, it's true. Because if it's true, this guy has just inadvertently published supporting evidence to show that Hunter Biden's money, the money he was getting from Burisma, was going to his dad, Joe Biden. So the money that Joe Biden was sending to Ukraine as aid, U.S. taxpayer dollars to Ukraine that flowed into Burisma, into his son's bank account, was going back into his pockets. This is unbelievable corruption, and this is supporting evidence for that. But this is the problem with, like, articles like this, right? Some well-respected reporter, well-respected by leftists, publishes something like this. And people think, wow, that guy is a legitimate guy. This stuff has all got to be legitimate. This stuff has all got to be vetted. This can't just be out of his imagination. This has to be real. And so people like Rachel Maddow go on her stupid little show where she spouts, like, real disinformation all the time, just lies, 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 whatever comes into her stupid head. She just says it, doesn't care if it's true, and she uses stuff like this as evidence to support her stupid positions, which are always wrong and always disproven. But anyway, so like everybody on CNN, everybody all over the place, they're going to use this article as proof that the Hunter Biden story has been debunked by legitimate journalists, by legitimate news agencies. No, it hasn't. No, it hasn't. This is an opinion article by a guy who's shilling for the Bidens. This is total BS. If it's not just purely out of his imagination, then it actually implicates Joe Biden in these crimes, in these dealings. He says at the beginning that that was all disinformation, and then he provides evidence for it. What a moron. But you know what? The left-wing media, it doesn't matter. The guy will never be fired. There will never be any consequences for this. The Washington Post, there will be never any. I have a buddy. Okay, this is how good the left is at like brainwashing people, right? I called a buddy of mine after the email scandal first broke. This guy's a leftist. He's voting for Biden. And I said, does the email scandal with Hunter Biden, does this change your vote? Does this change your mind at all? And the first thing that he said to me, that his knee-jerk reaction was, oh, you know, ever since the Hillary thing, email scandals have just been overplayed. Overplayed? What kind of response is that? If there was an email scandal about Trump, if there was an email scandal about Donald Trump Jr., something like that, even Melania, he would definitely still care about email scandals. But because it's about Hunter, you know, it's about another Democrat, oh, it's overplayed. The whole concept of email scandals, just overplayed. That's not a response. That's the reason he said that, right? The reason he said that is just because he just doesn't want to believe it. He just doesn't want to believe it. And so he'd rather ignore it than anything else. He'd rather pretend that it didn't exist. And a justification, the first justification that came to his mind was, email scandals are overplayed. I would just rather not think about it. I just put my head in the sand rather than think about another email scandal. My gosh, email scandal, goodness sakes. The point is, leftists have been so brainwashed to think, oh, anything bad that is said about Joe Biden, that's all just Russian disinformation. That's just all Trump's propaganda. And anything bad that's said about Trump, well, that's true. That's all legitimate because Trump's a bad man. I mean, these leftist voters, I feel so bad for them. I feel bad for anybody who watches Rachel Maddow. Anybody who watches Rachel Maddow, it's like I weep for you because your brain is just rotted, right? It's just twisted up by this evil witch woman. She doesn't even look trustworthy. Why do people watch her? I don't even understand that. There's so many things that she said on her show that have been unbelievably embarrassing for her. I mean, she said so many things that have been proven not just false, but gratuitously false. Like, she clearly said these things on purpose, knowing full well they were false. She just like lies to the American people night after night. She's proven to have done so many, many times, and people still watch her show and believe her. I mean, I don't even understand. I think a lot of her audience, though, whatever her ratings are, I don't know, I'd have to look, but I think whatever ratings are, I think at least half has got to be conservatives watching her just thinking, what a train wreck, right? That's the way people watch like those hoarders shows and other shows about people whose lives are nightmares. Like, it's the same reason why people watch Rachel Maddow. But anyway, I just wanted to read you that article, guys, and I wanted to put it out there that either this is a huge bombshell or this journalist, so-called, should never work in journalism ever again, ever, because he's a total hack and he's a total shill for the Biden campaign. He's obviously a shill anyway, whether it's true or not, he's a shill for the Biden campaign. But if it's true, supporting evidence to show that Hunter Biden's Burisma money went to Joe Biden. And that definitely needs to be investigated for a variety of reasons. Anyway, all this stuff is blowing up. There's just so much news about it. It's crazy. It's hard to keep up. But, you know, good luck, guys. I'm going to keep watching. I'm going to keep following this story. What I really hope is that I really hope a lot of this stuff gets uncovered before the election, because it doesn't look like it, right? It looks like this is going to be a sort of like vague scandal that leftists don't know what to believe about. And then election, right? I mean, people are already voting. I already voted because in California, you can already vote. I already voted. A lot of people have already voted. Naturally, I voted for Trump. Anyway, I hope this video educated you a little bit more about Joe Biden. And, you know, hopefully they catch him. They prove something. There's something can be done here. I mean, I know It's tricky because it's just before an election, but this is all very bad. I mean, this all looks really bad. This all is really bad. I've been saying it for, I think, like 2 years now. Well, Joe Biden absolutely is 100% corrupt. I mean, we've seen it. If you want to know more about this stuff, read the Peter Schweizer books. Those have all the corruption just laid out beautifully in there in the pages. There's a chapter in one of his books is called, I think it's Secret Empires. Secret Empires is the book. Get the book. I also read the newer one. I can't remember what the newer one is, but just get all of Peter Schweizer's books. They're amazing. The guy's a genius, and his research is legit, and it just outlines everything, all the Joe Biden's corruption, and it is immense. I mean, the man is definitely corrupt. And if you haven't seen my previous videos on Joe Biden's corruption, I highly recommend watching those. I will link those at the end of the video. You can click on them as the video closes. And the video is closing right now. So that's it for me. And remember, it's not that our liberal friends are ignorant. It's just they know so much that is not so. Good night.
There are going to be millions of Democrats that are going to vote with us this time around because they too want that promise kept. It was a promise for less government and less taxes and more freedom for the people.
You know, someone very profoundly once said many years ago that if fascism ever comes to America, it'll come in the name of liberalism.